All right, guys, so it's car season in Edmonton right now, and I kind of want to make a vlog about it, just so that everybody can have, like, a good time, a memorable experience, and of course if you can take one of these home. For the last couple of years, I've been trying to chase after one of these, and a lot of heartaches and a lot of disappointment, but I think most of it is because I was setting myself up for a disappointment, and I just wasn't really prepared for it. But luckily, I have a good friend that has a whole lot of these and a lot of experience. So maybe we can tap into his expertise and his experience, and maybe that could help you guys take home one of these and have a good time at the car show. I'll see you if he's home. Aramis! Oh, he's here. Let's see. Let's wait till he gets out here.
Hey, buddy.
How's it going, man?
Good, good. How's your day?
Good, good, man. Just did lots of work in the yard.
Say hi to the vlog.
What's up, everybody? Chico here.
All right, guys. So this is my good friend, family friend. He's going to show us his expertise, you guys, how to bring home one of these.
All right, guys. So Aramis is going to start out by, I guess, pointing out 5 key points to winning these trophies or standing out or making your car stand out in the judge's eyes. So I'll let him take over, and let's start with point number 1.
Just be genuine. Be a very nice person. Be approachable. This is going to help you a lot through all the 5 points that we're going to show you, and they're going to tie in very nicely what being a nice person gets you and where it's going to take you to the next level, right? So nobody likes going to a show. Yeah, you have a very nice car, but if you don't talk to them, they don't mean nothing to you. Yeah. And I think that's very important. That's one of the number 1 keys. That's why I made it the first thing to talk about, just to be genuine and overall a very nice person.
All right, guys. So be approachable, you guys. Like, you don't want to be that guy standing by his car and not being talkative or anything, and nobody wants to approach you, right? Because it's just, you're kind of almost putting a barrier between you and the crowd. And it's called a car show for a reason, because you want to show off your car, you want to show off yourself and why you stand out at the crowd, right?
You want to tell them about your build, tell them about yourself, get them to know. You want them to find something in common with you, so later on they follow you, and this helps you get a lot of other things later on.
That's number 1.
So number 2, dos, quality over quantity. It's always been talked about, but nobody seems to grasp the idea. If you can't afford it, wait for it. The car is not going nowhere. Save up your money for it and buy good quality parts. You necessarily don't have to go to the top end, because as we go through the list, you'll see why, but you want to not go the bottom, so your car maintains a quality which show people always look at. So always try to stay in the middle or up when you can, or if you foresee that you are gonna need higher parts, then go in the middle, and I will show you why that will be important in the other steps. But just remember that it's not always how much you can get done in 1 year. Just good quality parts will go a long way.
It's basically, it's a marathon. It's not a sprint, you guys.
Right.
Because these builds are not something over time. And don't be fooled, you guys. A lot of these ones, or a lot of these cars that you guys see on, like, Instagram or on other YouTube channels, for example, let's say this one. It took you how long to build this car?
Well, my car was a 2012. Where you look at it right there, it was 2015. So 3 years to get to where I wanted the car to be shown in places like that, right?
Yeah.
And you don't want to set yourself a failure, right?
Yeah, because a lot of these guys, they'll show you, like, oh, building an Evo in 10 minutes, but it took them 3, 2, 4, or 5 years. So that's the thing, is don't be fooled, you guys. Take your time. It is a marathon, it's not a sprint, because it's basically built.
That's right.
Not bought.
That's right.
And that's the key.
It could be bought towards later on, and that's where a lot of key points come in. But at the beginning, you're forking all this. So take your time with it. Enjoy it. It's not a 100-meter race. It's a marathon. Yeah. And take your time with it so people can start seeing the evolution of your car.
All right, guys, so that's number two. So quality over quantity, you guys. So take your time, save up, don't compromise and buy. For example, let's say wheels. You can't afford those TEs, but you know what? Save up and get the right fitment, get the ones that you want, because you will. That's right.
Yeah.
Because you will regret it, because you're going to buy that set of rims and rush out and get it. You might be happy at that moment, then realize it's not the right fitment, or it's like a knockoff or a replica. And to most guys that are car guys, we'll call you out on it.
Yeah.
And you don't want to feel.
Yeah, and don't forget that most of us are on budgets. Yeah. Do you want to go spend $2,000 on replicas and then forking out $5,000 on and other expensive wheels? Yeah. You could have just put the extra $3,000 and get the right wheels.
If you want those BBS, you want those Advance, you want those T's, save up for you guys.
Yeah.
It will. Quality over quantity. So let's move on to number
three. So number three, be different. Now, I got to give a lot of credit to the judges, because in the class that I was, it was an Evo 10. And if you're in Alberta, that's 50% of the show.
Yeah, or I guess not just Alberta, I think
everywhere. Overall, right? You know, the Evo is a very popular platform to build.
Yes.
Yeah. So I knew I was going against 20, 30 good quality Evos. So what I had to do is I had to be different. So number three is different. What did I do to be different? I went with a very flashy wrap. Everybody knows me as the Gold Evo. You can see that one with the wing down there and everything. But if you notice, I was the first Evo in Alberta with airbags. Not primarily what I would like, because I am a performance guy and I like performance, but that's what I had to do to be different and draw people to, you know, see what I was doing. Yeah. So I had to do something drastic to draw people to like me, to follow me, to see the things that I was doing. Yeah. And that's what I did by accomplishing that with bags and a wrap. I went with a very flashy wrap, and everybody knows my car in Alberta and the bags. So that was something that threw me over the edge, you know, with a lot of people. And in shows, the judges saw all that and the quality that I had, and that helped me a lot in getting trophies as well too.
All right, guys, so you have to realize when Ramos wrapped his Evo, it was already popular in the States, but it was starting to gain popularity in Alberta and in Canada, right? So he was one of the very first guys to wrap his vehicle. Actually, he wrapped it really nice too, and in a really nice color.
Yeah.
And that's, I guess he made himself stand out. He took a risk, and the risk paid off, you guys. Not all risk is gonna pay off, but there are going to be the ones that will make you stand out.
That's right. People were doing at that time a lot of different type of paint schemes, and wrapping was starting to come in, and they were doing a lot of the plastic dip.
Yeah.
You know, and for me, I think doing a wrap was different, but picking a crazy colors, and I will have to give props to my wife on that, because she actually picked the colors. Yeah. So I give Caesar what's, you know, for Caesar, but you know, she picked the color, and I'm glad from that on, my car was like, wow.
So you guys have that, like, it's, you know, big risks, big rewards, you guys, but all right.
Yeah, you know, bags was not really what I really enjoyed, but I did that because I wanted to stand out.
Yeah.
And then after I drew some of that crowd, then I'm like, okay, bags are out. I got to do something else.
Yeah.
Because I was, you know, missing what I loved about the car.
Yeah, you got to, I guess, you have to evolve your car.
Right.
What is in at the moment. And that's just it. A build will never be done. You know why? Because times do change, and you got to go with the times, and you got to take big risks.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So let's move on to number four.
Multimedia. Remember about being nice and being approachable? Well, this is where it's going to help you with multimedia. Remember all those people that you talked to at shows, people that you exposed to, you built, and you were nice to? Well, you know what? They will not say no to following you. So all these people will work into followers, and your multimedia's Instagram and Facebook will start growing. And the only way that's going to happen is by standing out, being nice, and just doing things in your car that you enjoy and sharing it with people. But if you're not approachable, that becomes a hard effort to do. And if you do well at it, then your followers just go up. My account at its peak went up to close to 38,000 followers in one of my accounts. And my pictures were just blowing up and people were just following. My only regret is not concentrating on YouTube at that time and using my followers for that. I just primarily stuck with Instagram, but it helped me a lot. And you know, being nice gets you a lot of places. It might take you a little longer, but once you get there, it does pay off.
So you guys are probably wondering what social media has got to do with a car show or getting a judge's attention at a car show. But they do check up on you. So basically, when you register for the car show, they'll ask you for your Instagram name or your handle or any social media that you're on, submit a couple of pictures to get approved to go into the car show. But with that social media platform that you sent in, let's say example, Instagram, yeah, they will check your Instagram to see how many followers you have.
Remember that they're going to pick whatever is gonna benefit you, because after you win a trophy, what's the next thing you're gonna do?
You're gonna post it on your social media. That's basically free advertising for them.
That's right.
So that you won, you're a big social media guy. If you have a big following and you're showing off one of these hardwares, it's free advertising for them. So it's going to, I know it's kind of stupid, but it does sway the judge's opinions on choosing you.
It does.
And let's say if you're neck and neck with another competitor with just as fantastic build, this will give you the advantage.
Absolutely.
Right.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So that's why social media is a big part of the.
But you can only get there if you're nice.
Yeah.
Remember that.
Yeah.
Who wants to follow an ass? You know what I mean.
So get out there, team up with one of your local photographers that are into cars too. They'll be more than happy to take you guys out, take some beautiful pictures, you guys, because you're gonna tag them into your Instagram too, and that'll blow them up.
You know, when you buy a house, it's location, location, location. Yeah. When you're in social media, it's exposure, exposure, exposure.
Yeah. All right. So team up with your local photographer and get on the social media, guys, to win one of these. So let's talk about number
five. Okay, guys. So number five, it's a touchy one for everybody because it's a tough one to get to. But it works. Sponsorships. Yeah, I know what you're saying. My car is built, not bought. Don't get me wrong. The fruits of your built car is what's gonna get you here. The fruits of you being nice to people in shows, having a quality build, and having a good social media channel is gonna give you these perks. So why not take advantage of them, right?
Yeah. So just to touch up on that, Aramis is saying without those four first points that we talked about, number five won't happen. And how that basically attracts the judges' attention is when you get sponsors,
you get a lot more quality parts.
If you're sponsored or if you're sponsored, you're basically somebody now.
Yeah, remember, all your posts are being tagged sponsors too, and all the sponsors are going to get you nice things on your vehicle that are going to help you win trophies. So yeah, your car is built, not bought, but you know what, after you've done some good building to it, why not get somebody to buy into it and help you build your car and get you those trophies, right?
Yeah. Saving some money in your pocket does go a long ways, right?
You know what? Some guys change 2-3 wheel sets in a span of 5 years. And I mean, I just ordering some new wheels for a new build that I'll be doing now. And trust me, prices are not cheap. And if you got somebody to help you with that, why not? It's the fruit of your own hard work. Remember that. A lot of people's like, oh, you know, it's you being sponsored. He's this. Trust me, sponsorships are not
given.
Easy to get. They're not given.
They're not given.
It's hard work. You have to earn it.
You have to write a letter and everything. And it's just
everything. And if you don't have, you know, nice personality, you're approachable, your social media is not up there, you don't have a quality car to start with, a nice base to start with, nobody's going to look at you. So this will put you over the edge in a lot of shows too, and it will help you get a lot of stuff. You know, I was blessed to be sponsored by great people, you know. My build later on in life was sponsored by the Tint Studio, and we changed the whole wrap and we did other stuff, and I couldn't have got there if I didn't have a good sheet, and what we did helped me get a lot of hardware that, you know, I'm proud of. You know, I'm really happy. My Evo was one of the cars that I enjoyed the best. And that takes me to the last thing that I have to say. When you go into car shows, don't forget that you're not going there to win trophies. You go there to meet people, to have fun. Don't set yourself up for failures. Many times I've gone to shows, and you know what? I don't go thinking, oh, I'm going to win this show. No. Don't forget to have fun of it. Don't forget why you started building your car. It's for the love of the cars, for the love of doing something that you enjoy. So if you go at a show and setting yourself up that you're going to win and you don't, that might just bring you lots of steps down where you're not going to feel motivated to do stuff. And you're just going to stop enjoying it. And that's not the point of a car show. The point of a car show is to go out there, meet some great people, see everybody's rights, respect the rights, and understand and appreciate what they've done to those rights. Because some people do their own work as well too, and you got to give props to that, right? Mm-hmm. So don't forget to enjoy yourself and have fun at the show. That's the number one reason why you do that. The trophies are just the icing on the cake. If you get it, great. If you don't, hey, there's a next show.
That is a great point, you guys. At the end of the day, have fun. Because you know what? Even if you don't take home a trophy, don't forget, at these car shows, there are potential sponsors out there, you guys, because there's a lot of local vendors that go to the car show to basically promote their own product or their own shop. And they're out there looking. And if you stand out and if you're approachable and you're a fun person and they know that you got a great social media and that could benefit them, they put a face to the name.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Yeah. And they know that you are a good representative or ambassador to their brand. That goes a long way. And to me, guys, that is a big win. Even more than the trophy, guys. You know what? Because that's building relationships for the future. All right, guys. So I'm hoping you guys are enjoying the vlog at the moment. And if you guys are, don't forget to smash that subscribe button and turn on the notification. But yeah, Aramis just gave us some very, very valid, great pointers for guys that are enthusiasts and want to go hard at it and get that trophy. But for guys like myself and maybe not as an enthusiast, right, and just trying to enjoy the car show, and maybe the trophy is not just the most important thing, but for me the most important thing, you guys, go out, enjoy your guys' cars, enjoy your build, show them off, and that's very rewarding in itself, right? I just want to give you guys a little bit of insight on my own experience at my very first car show. I didn't bring any cleaning supplies. I was so excited to go to the show that I forgot to bring any supplies. So don't forget to bring cleaning supplies. Don't forget to bring water, sunscreen, because those are hot days. Because usually car shows, well, most car shows are in the winter. In the summer. So just go out there and enjoy your car, enjoy your build, enjoy whatever you guys put into your cars, your modifications. That is just enjoyable and the most fun experience. Because if you're just going out there hardcore expecting to win like I did, you're going to set yourself up for disappointment. A lot of times there's going to be guys that are been in the game for a long time or have a deep pocket, and they're going to buy the nicest, biggest, best, big wings, big body kits, big rims, just everything. And yeah, if you're thinking they're coming in and you're going to win, unless you have a deep pocket and a whole crew behind you, you're probably most likely not going to win. And that's what happened to me. And over the years, I learned to enjoy it more as just going as a spectator or just going in as a car and enjoying with some friends. That will go a long ways, you guys. And if you get a trophy, that's the, I guess, what is it, cherry on top? Yeah. So, again, guys, don't forget to smash the subscribe button, turn on the notification, and we'll see you guys in the next week's vlog. By the way, also, if we missed out a couple important pointers, or you guys think that it's important and you want to add to the vlog, put it in the comment below, you guys, and we'll respond to you guys' comments. And any comment is appreciated, you guys. So, We'll see you guys in next week's vlog. See ya.